Hi there, welcome back to my channel Scrap and Coffee. In today's video I'm going to show you something a little bit different, just like in last one. I'm going to show you how I've made these little shadow box photo frames. And I'm going to show you two different ways. One is with a 12 by 12 sheet that will give you this size. It will end up being, the outside will be 6 inches by 6 inches, and the photo frame that you have will be 4.5 by 4.5. And I'm also going to show you how you can make one with two sheets of 8.5 by 11 that you cut down a little bit to make a frame that's going to be 5 by 5 inches on the outside, and then the inside will be 3 3/4 by 3 3/4. And when you do this, well, this is obviously done with white, but then you can use, if you print on 8.5 by 11 paper, then you can use that. Because for this one, the 12 by 12, I've used a black base and then decorated. That's what I'm going to show you. Because I can print on 12 by 12 paper. That's what I did here. This is with pattern paper that I've printed off myself. But I get a really bad quality of print when I print on 12 by 12 paper with my printer. Because this is actually the same pattern. It just printed off totally different. So that's why I do the 12 by 12 with the black base. And then I decorate it. So I'm going to show you that. And what I'm using here is a digital collection called Farmhouse Collections by Knitwit Collections. And I'm really thinking like, do I say that right? But I believe it's called Farmhouse Collection. But I have a link down below in the description box, so you can check it out. Really nice collection that I'm definitely going to be using for an album as well. But for now, I'm going to show you how to make this box. Okay, so I'm starting off with the 12 by 12 sheet of paper to make the largest size box. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how you can score and cut. And if you do it the way that I'm doing it, then you can do it with pattern paper, because there are no score lines or fold lines visible once it's done. You're only gonna see the connection points there, right? That's it. This is not glued down yet, so that's why it's a little wonky, but you can definitely glue it down as well. If you understand what I'm doing, you can actually do this with any size of square piece of paper. So what I like to do is like to work with a measurement that I can divide and can work with 1/8 of an inch. And with 12 by 12 I can do that. What you want to do is visually you want to split it in half. So that would be 6 inches. And then those 6 inches I'm going to divide in half again. So that would be 3 inches. And that's where I'm going to score, at the 3-inch mark. All the way down. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. So in this case that would be on the 9-inch mark. I'm going to turn it and do the same thing on the other side. So again, at that 3-inch mark and on the 9-inch mark. And then let me get something where I can... The 4 outer squares we are going to cut away, but I'm not going to do that yet because it's going to help me with scoring for now. But you can cut it away now if you want to. But these rectangles here that we've created, that's where we want to divide that in 4 even pieces. Yeah, I'm not sure how to explain it in English well. But this is 3 inches. So halfway of this would be 1.5. So I'm going to score at 10.5 inches. And you only have to score in between your score lines. So I'm going here, so I'm sure that I'm in the right score line. And then I give my pressure. And then I want to divide that in half again. So that would be 3/4 of an inch. So I'm going to score at 9 3/4. And I'm going to do the same thing here. I want to divide this in half again. So 3/4 makes 11 1/4. So I've divided this in 4 equal parts. And I'm going to do that on all 4 sides. So where I'm scoring, to make it a little bit easier, is 9 3/4. 9 3/4, 10.5, and 11 1/4. And I'm going to do that on all 4 sides. So I'll be back when I've done that. Okay, I've done all four sides. Now I'm going to make a little mark. And I'm going to use white because it's easy to see. Don't worry about it because you won't be able to see this in the end. But I'm going to start at my halfway point. So that's the 6-inch side for this 12-inch piece. And then I'm going to move to the right-hand side. 3/4 inch. I want to have the same space as one of these pieces here. So I'm going to move up 3/4 inch. So that's at the 6 3/4 inch mark. I'm just going to make a little mark there. And I'm doing that on all four sides. So I'm just turning it around. Make my mark. Because then I don't have to get my pencil in and out. It's just done. All four sides. And at this point, I'm going to cut out the 4 squares. And I like to move it over to the bumpy side for that. Because it's a little bit easier to see. And I'm just using my scissors and cut out that square that I've marked earlier. And I'm cutting on the outside of the score line. So I'm cutting away the score line. And I'm doing that for all 4 sides again. Okay, make sure you turn it over to the dented side because you want to score all your score marks on the same side. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to make a diagonal score line. For that, I am going to use my black line here on my scoreboard. I'm going to line up my mark that I've made here with the first score line here. So not the corner, but 1 score line up. That's what you want to line up. And that's what the black line makes really easy. I'm having it there and then the mark there and I score. There we go. And then I'm going to put this one back up. And I'm going to align my little mark with the 6-inch mark. That's just easy to do that. The same for every side. I'm lining it up there. My cut here is lined up with the 8 1/4 inch mark. And I want to go back to the left-hand side. 3/4 inch. So that is at the 7 1/2 inch mark. There I am going to score up to the intersection of the diagonal score line and the score line here on the second part. So where you just reach your diagonal score line to up to that point you're going to score. There we go. Like that. I'll try to catch it in the light. So this you can do now for all 4 sides. So again, I'm lining the diagonal line up. Line that up with the 6-inch mark and go back the 3/4 inch to the 7 1/2 inch mark. And again, you see that this is the same space as I have divided here. So that's the measurement that you are going to use. Okay, that's done on all 4 sides. Now I'm going to get this scoreboard out of the way because we have to make 1 more score line, but it's not so easy to do in this scoreboard. For me at least. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to score, and I'm going to use this one for it, here on the diagonal as well. So I'm going to line up my ruler with the intersection that I've made here. And I know it's hard to see on the black. So I'm going from this point up to that point in a diagonal line. So you want to line that up nicely. So in there. So with a ruler and scoring tool, you can just make that score line. Like that. Now, if you have the explosion board, the explosion board from your memory keepers, then you can also use this one. And I haven't really used it a lot. But you can line this up in here. And let me just get that thing out of here. You can line that corner up because you already have that nice diagonal line there. So you can line this up and use that to score up to the diagonal score line again. Same thing. So if you have it by coincidence, then you can use that. Okay, at this point we can start folding. So I'm going to fold it over. I'm going to start on one side. I'm going to fold all the 4 score lines here. And I'm just gonna give that a quick burnish, but don't worry about it too much. Okay, that's done. Now I'm going to score on the longest diagonal score line that we've made. Again, I always fold towards the bumpy side of the score line. So you're going to fold all the score lines in the same direction. Open that. Now I'm going to fold on the diagonal score line that we've made last here. So you just pinch that one. And actually this is enough. It's already starting to make the shape that you want. So just pinch that. And you want to fold on the score line here that goes straight. That one is the one that you want to give a pinch as well. There we go. So now if I fold this, I am going to push here, on here, to make this like that. But I want to have this standing up straight. And I want to have the little triangle shape made here. And actually, if you make your folds, it's almost going in that direction already. So I'm trying to show you what I did. But this is what that looks like. And then you are going to roll it over in the end. Completely roll it in. So you're going to do this on all four sides. Okay, so I've folded on this and I will show you what you are going to do to assemble it, because you are going to roll it all over like I showed you before. And this is can be a little bit tricky. You're going to fold the other one and you are going to place this in there. Do the next one. And like I said, it is a little bit tricky. You can glue this eventually if you want to. I will do that. So this is, and now the last one is the most tricky, because now everything is gonna go loose, because this little thing here, you wanna get that underneath the first one. And this side has to go in there. So you wanna, you have to, yeah, work that a little bit, hold some things in place. Probably you will get loose and you have to do some things over again. But there we go. So this will stay in place just like this. If you wanna glue it, you can put a little bit of glue underneath your connection points, and then it will stay together. So this is the base. I'm going to decorate this a little bit, so I like to open it back up, and I'm going to put some patterned paper on the inside. And I have a little piece here that I've prepared already. This is a scrap piece, but you want it to be at least, I would say, 4¾. Yes, and the maximum, let's say, between 4¾ and 5¾. So my piece is not square, but it will fit. It will all be covered up by the side pieces here. So I'm just going to glue this down. Most important thing is that it's wide enough to cover your whole frame part, and that it's not too big, because you want to stay in between your score lines. That's the most important thing. And then I've also prepared strips to decorate the outside. So what am I going to do? I'm going to turn it over, and I have square strips that are a little bit longer. That let me see. I have to think about this. That are shorter. And a longer one, and I will tell you the measurements in a second. And then I have a piece that I have cut in an angle, and I will show you that as well. So you want to have the longest one the closest to the middle, and then the one with the angle goes on the second one, and then the short one on the third one. So the long one, I believe, is 5¾, but let me check that for you. Yes, 5¾. Then this one is also 5¾ by 5/8 of an inch, by the way. By 5/8 of an inch. So this one is also 5¾, but cut in an angle. So I will show you how you can do that. And then these are, I believe, a little bit over 5 inches. Just a hair over. So that's how I'm going to glue that on all three sides. But how do you make the angle? And now I have to make sure that I do that with the right one. Yes. Okay, so this strip is 5/8 of an inch in height. So what am I going to do? I am going to make a little mark, 5/8 of an inch from the cut edge. Just mark that. It's actually really easy. And then I'm going to cut from that mark up to the point there to make a 45 degree angle. There we go. And I'm going to ink that a little bit so I don't forget. And then we can stick that down. So I'm going to glue all these pieces down. What you want to make sure of, before I forget, is one thing. This one is going to be lined up right there. You want to have the short strip on the third section to line up with this one on this side. Doesn't matter what happens here, because you are going to hide that with tucking it in. So that doesn't matter, but you just want to make sure that this is lined up somewhat. So that's all you have to take in consideration. Okay, so now this is all decorated and I can turn it over again and I can assemble it once more. So I am going to make those folds again and just roll it up and have that go into each other, right? So I'm just holding it in place on as much places as I can, and then there we go. So if you want, you can glue this all shut, right? So at this point, you can add your photo or your decorations, whatever you like to do with it. I'm not going to do anything with the back because, yeah, you're not going to see that, right? So now I'm going to show you how you also can make one with two 8.5 by 11. So I've printed out a pattern paper. This is from the solids from the Farmhouse collection. And I'm going to cut this down to 10 inches because it's easy for the scoring. You can do this with 11, but it's this is a little bit easier, so that's why I'm doing 10. And I'm going to cut it to 5 inches. And you need two pieces of that. So two pieces 10 by 5 inches. I'm going to get my scoreboard in. I'm going to put the 10 inside on top. And again, I want to divide this, right? So the middle would be half, and the middle will be 5. And then the half of that will be at 2.5 inches. So that's where I'm going to score. And then here again, 2.5 inches this way from 5 is at 7.5 inches. And then my outer two flaps, I want to divide in equal parts again. So for that, I need to have 5/8 of an inch separation. So I'm going to score at the 5/8 inch mark. 1.25. And then 2, 4, 5, 1 7/8. Now you can turn it around and do the same thing, but I'm just going to go here. I'm going to 8 1/8 of an inch. And then 2, 4, 5, 8 3/4. 2, 4, 5, and 9 3/8. There we go. Now I'm going to turn this around where the 5/8 inch side is on top. And I'm going to go to the center. That's 2.5 inches. And from there, I'm going to add 5/8 of an inch. So that makes 3 1/8 of an inch. And I'm going to mark that. I'm going to do the same thing on this side at 3 1/8 of an inch. And because my score lines are really terrible to see on this pattern paper, I'm also going to mark the second score line here, where I want to line up the diagonal score line. So I'm just going to mark that really light so I know where I have to go. And do the same thing here. So again, I'm not going to the fourth, but to the 1, 2, 3rd score line. And I'm going to make that same diagonal score line as we did on the 12 by 12 paper, right? So you make that diagonal score line. Line that back up here. And now I'm going to go 5/8 of an inch from my cut edge back to the left side. So that's at 4 3/8 of an inch. And I'm going again score up to the diagonal score line. And I will do the same thing here. 4 3/8. And now finally we also have to make that diagonal score line. And again, I just think this is really easy. It gives me an accurate score line, so I'm going to use it. But you can also do this with your ruler and a scoring tool, right? There we go. So we actually did the same thing, only this is only one side. So again, I'm going to fold on all those score lines. Make sure you are lined up on the edges. Fold on your diagonal score line. So I'm just following the same steps. Now I'm going to fold on the diagonal line here that we did last. Give that a good pinch. And on that straight part here. And then we did the same thing as we did on the other one. So I'll repeat that right over here. So also these we can roll in to create this part, but we need two of these. So you're going to do this one more time. I've already prepared that other one. What you're going to do is you're going to place them on top where the center part is lined up with each other. If you want to, you can glue this on top of each other. And then you're going to assemble the same way as you did with your 12x12 paper. Here it's, if you glue it down, it's easier. It's all staying in place. Now it's not, so I have to work that a little bit more. There we go. Again, you have to work it a little bit, right? To make sure it's all staying in place, but there we go. So now you have your, this one is a little bit smaller, made from your pattern paper. I would again cut a piece of pattern paper here to do something nice here. If you have double-sided paper, then of course you don't have to. You can just have that other side of your paper showing. That's totally fine as well, right? So I would do the decorating of the center part the same thing as I did on this one. So the top one you will have some pattern paper, and then this is what you have. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make, I think, two in this size, two in this size, and then maybe even smaller one with 8x8. And I'm going to make a little collage of my photo frames, and I'm going to attach them together. And you will do that on the back. So you will have the back side lined up, because this is only 5/8 of an inch high. This one is 3/4 of an inch high, and your 8x8 will be even a little bit less high. So I want to have that difference of depth showing on the front, and you don't see it here, but you can see it on the side then a little bit. And then I'm going to make, just with a piece of scrap paper, you can just glue them together, right? So it all holds, and you can just make your little collage. I'm also going to do something on the inside, right? So I've prepared some pieces here for this frame. So I have a photo. All of this comes from the collection that I have here. I have a photo. I have just some pieces cut out, backed it with black because I like how that pops. And I'm going to make a little collage here with a photo. In this one, I will probably also do a photo, and then in the really small ones, you can do a really small photo, or you can just do some decorations only. So this is how it comes together, and then you can make some nice wall decoration with this and have some photos in there. In the next one, thank you for watching. Bye bye.